All right, guys, it's about 10 to 3 in the morning. Here's the Residence Inn. 10 to 3, Friday morning. Snowstorm has come in. Here's the Expedition ready to go. Ranger's all loaded up in there. We are at the beginning of the journey. 2:50. Ranger's ready. We'll see you guys at the first stop. Alright guys, this is our first state line for the day, Nebraska. It was unplanned, by the way. So what you see is we're 5.5 hours in, 374 miles in, and what we've got is a couple of diversions today. We made it from St. Louis to Kansas City on I-70 as planned, but then I-70, something went wrong out over in Kansas, so they diverted us to I-29 north up to Nebraska, and then I-29 north got blocked by a wreck, so we ended up going on to like Bob's Farm Road, which turned on to Larry's Farm Road, which turned on to Dave's Farm Road, and spent about an hour and a half out in the middle of nowhere in Kansas. So now we're diverted up to Nebraska, and we are taking a diagonal over. I think we're going to hit I-80 and take I-80 across Kansas and most of Colorado, and then take a diagonal down to Denver. So a couple of diversions. The weather's much different today. Pretty good snowstorm out of St. Louis. We had a couple hours of snow there. And then it's been clear now that we've been north of Kansas City. But it's pretty much 0 degrees up here. So everything's frozen pretty hard, including my windshield washing fluid. So, all right, there's first update. Just showing you guys a little bit of through the windshield here. This is deep inside the interior of Nebraska. We're on I-80 westbound. We're more towards the eastern edge of it, just past Lincoln. Anyway, we're going to be on here for about 200 miles before we start, take that big left and diagonal down towards Denver. So, anyway, just truck after truck. You can see what we got coming up here. We got dueling trucks. This is probably the most frustrating part of the trip. It's one truck wants to go half a mile faster than another truck, and we just get stuck behind them time and time again. But anyway. Just like give you a little update, a little actual through the lens. Well, hello, YTPC. This is Dave coming to you from the mobile lounge. Not Uncle Willie's, but my own. We're inside the Expedition. I'm going to show you, I'm going to break up between talking to you like this, and then I'll show you some things out the windshield as I can. Now, the windshield's pretty dirty, but at least let you see what it looks like in case some of you have not had the pleasure of driving through the interior of Nebraska in the middle of dead of winter. That's something everyone should, you should all be made part of this. So I'm going to smoke a cigar. I'm going to break a couple rules. Smoke a cigar in the car. But, gosh, I don't think anybody else can be in this car for months. So I'll have it cleaned out before then. I pull out my Aleva V. I know somebody's going to give me crap for doing all this while we're in the mobile lounge mobilizing, but it is what it is. So there you go, the Aleva V. Churchill size, the one I smoked in the lounge in the paddock the other day. Alright, gonna get it cut and lit, and I'll be back to you in a minute. Look at that, got it cut. Pretty proud of that. Couldn't use my normal method of putting it on the table, right? Couldn't do that today. But But I snipped it. I don't think I got the whole cap, so I think we're good. You remember I told you I'd throw this one in there, Mike Cigars. It's just a nice single. See how it lights. When I'm drinking some Red Bull, it's a good on the road drink in my opinion. Guys, I was able to grab my microphone. I was wondering, I'm gonna try it here, get a test, see if it's any better. The sound quality is pretty rough on those earlier ones. I got this thing lit pretty well. Guess I have to redo this. My Aliva V. Wind is brutal out here. Wow. It's that famous north to south, Canada to Mexico wind that Midwest is so famous for. Wyoming's probably the most famous for it, but it's certainly no slouch here in Nebraska. All the snow is blowing, pretty much all the snow they plowed off the freeway is blowing straight across right now. I sure understand why it was such a dangerous place to be as a pioneer or as a cowboy. If you got caught out here in the weather, it would be pretty dangerous today in a modern car, much less on a horse. Today's been a little bit of a struggle travel-wise. So I can confirm that the country is in a deep freeze. I don't think we've seen a temperature over 20 degrees from D.C. to St. Louis. And then when we got up this morning, we left St. Louis at 2:45 and it had already snowed a couple inches. It was 1 degree and it's been pretty much 1 degree the whole day. Let me check the tripometer here. So we're currently 6 hours and 51 minutes into the trip. We've done about 470 miles. The wind really gets us, man. And the Ford Expedition is like a sailboat with that giant side down the side catching the wind. Anyway, the reason I tell you how long, because I don't think we've seen over 1 degree all day in the 7 hours we've been on the road. It's crystal clear out. I can't complain about the weather. Just windy and super cold. Let's see if I can get you some of this video of the snow blowing across. Well, it's not coming across as good on camera, but it's just constant. All those white, wispy looking things, just the wind kicking across. So Youssef and Jacques out there in South Africa, you're probably getting a kick out of this. 0 degrees Fahrenheit, which is minus something in Celsius. So I can't look it up while I'm driving. You guys are probably cooking there. I know you guys are. It's crazy to think it's summer there. Well, hey guys, just so I give you an update. We're now 8 hours and 7 minutes into the trip. Still smoking my Aliva V. It's been very nice, very relaxing. I didn't I didn't freight train this one. Trip is going really well. I'm gonna show you. Having what are we? 70, 80 miles further. We're cruising along about 82 miles an hour on cruise control. The Expedition's got a nice front-looking radar, so you just set it for 82. It's the speed limit here in Nebraska is 75 on I-80. In Wyoming, it's actually 80, so it's kind of nice. So I set it for 82, and we let it go. So that's kind of how I can do this with you guys. I'm not too worried about speed or looking for cops. It's funny, my house back in Maryland, I've driven away, I've only been gone, not even 2 days, and we had a spigot freeze and our furnace quit working. So my wife is dealing with all that, but it's like the house knew I drove away. Anyway, take a look. So if you guys ever think I'll take I-80 instead of I-70 to see a different part of the country, I wouldn't. Or at least not if that is your only reason. It looks, I-70 and I-80 look almost identical to each other. It's interesting, we got, I think, at least three truck drivers. Jim from CJ's Garage, retired truck driver. And then we have Doug, Truckin' Piper. And then we have Bob, Truckin' Piper Bob, all our truck drivers. So, I can't imagine doing this every day for a living, but hats off to you guys. Not sure what else to tell you. That's it for the update for now. That's the 8 hour update. Well, we just crossed into Colorado. We're in the very northeast corner of Colorado, and it doesn't look a whole lot different than Nebraska here, that's for sure. Got some cool looking hills up here. Wow. I keep from bouncing around so much, sorry. That's it. Let's do a quick trip check for you. We're at 10 hours and 7 minutes, 732 miles to go. All right, there's your 10-hour check. So it's our last stop for gas in the middle of nowhere, actually in Colorado. I decided to do a 360 for you, see what it looks like out here. There's my boy taking a dump. Man, it is remote out here. In fact, the only thing to really even zoom in for you is got a Black Angus cows out here. That is it. Look how desolate it is. Crazy. Imagine some people love it out here. Well, we did it, guys. 12 and a half hours and 911 miles, and we are in Denver. And there's my boy walking out to pick up his boy. Well, hey guys, I'm just doing a wrap up, finish the video up and get it posted for you. Just coming to you from inside my son's house. We made it. It was a really great trip. I really can't complain about anything. Even the diversion from I-70 up to I-80 really only cost us about an hour, maybe a little bit more. So really, turned out I-70 was closed because of a huge blizzard, snow conditions, several semis had jackknifed, so they closed the whole freeway. So lucky we didn't get caught up in that, or it could have been a lot worse. So we're home, gonna go out for dinner with my boy. I've got, the next 2 days are nice, just sitting here, being here, spending the weekend with Sean, and then, I'll head over to Wyoming Monday morning. I'll probably leave here around 9. So that's really it. I'll probably try to do a video for you tomorrow. We'll see. Tomorrow and Sundays might be a little sketchy. We'll see how it goes. But I just want to say hi. I hope you guys had a great Friday. Hope you have a good weekend. And hopefully we'll talk again tomorrow. Bye, you guys.